Well, good evening and welcome to Sea Fishing with CJ, back on the beach.
We're down on the beach.
I was filming a video this morning for the TonysTackle Seafishing Channel competition, and I managed to get some quite good bait. So I thought, well, I need to get down the beach and give it some. So I'm down the beach this evening, two rods out. One's got fresh outs on, the other one's got rat lug. See if we get any difference in the two sort of types of bait. One's fixed ball, one's multiplier. And at the moment, we're casting into the moonlight. You can see that, I don't know if the camera's picking up the moonlight. I don't, probably not. Okay, but that's what we're doing. So, no more ado. I'll put the camera back on when something happens. But catch you later. Nice fight. Stop that camera. So I just want a bit more line out because we want to do off the ground. That'll do. Give us several wraps around the spool. Got the casting cannon over the capstan once. So just over the capstan once. That's not going anywhere. Okay. Lay it out on the ground. Open the bail arm. Don't forget to do that. So definitely schoolboy mistake. Schoolboy error. And out we go. Yeah, a little twitchy knob on the left hand rod. Oh yes, that's developing. Developing a bit more. Yeah, go on, really give it a walloping, walloping, wallop. Got some nice baits on there. Oh, it's looking better still. What should I do? Should I strike into it or should I let it develop? I think I'm going to strike into that. Ooh, feels like something on there. Something definitely tugging. I've got a stone gone down in the top of my boot. Really quite painful. Right, again, I'm not declaring the target species yet, but you'll know because you'll see me dancing. Not a big fish this, if it is, there is a fish on there still. Yeah, there's a fish there. Yeah, there is a fish there. Or rather, there was a fish there. Damn, that came off just in the surf. Definitely saw the fish. Yes. I'm thinking bigger hooks. What do we reckon? What do we reckon?
wind it, I don't think.
Rigging his rig, speed rigging his rig. Three baits out there, they're nice big baits.
Just coming off wound it and there's been enough bait on the hook to fucking rag that.
Happened on this right end rod for a while now, so let's wind that in and freshen the bait up, because I can't believe that nothing's happened on this, because they're lovely fresh outs, so they've probably been eaten.
Oh, hello, hello, we've got a bait on the right end rod, so let's get the camera on that. Yeah. Fish think I've put the camera on and so it's stopped biting, but what he doesn't know is that the camera I've just put on is on a 15 second reel. And I've already got the bite, I hope. But it's gone a bit quiet. Need it to settle. I'll say that, I don't know, I think the hooks are too small for it. Until I catch something, you see what sort of size they are. Oh, that's a bit more like it. What do I do? Do I leave it and wait for it to go again? Or, I mean, it's gone quiet now, hasn't it? That did look like a sawbill. And they quite often just sit and settle up. Well, we'll give it a little pause and see what happens. Oh, still going. Nothing monstrous. There's a surprise, it's a flounder. Hey, flounder. I wasn't anticipating one of them. Got a flounder. Right, so there we go. Nice little flounder.
So we're going to try something different, a big long flowing trace, single fresh out worm on the end of it, but with size, I don't know, 3-0 hooks, see if we can't pick up the winkle out a little codling, which is what I would like to catch, I must admit. So it's, we can call it pulley rig, up and over pulley rig, yeah, so.
Rattling bite on the left-hand rod again. said, it's developed.
I'm going to leave it and I'm going to have a cup of tea.
What do we reckon? Left end rod, definitely going, isn't it? Just got that camera for it. There we go, little knock on the left end rod.
There we go.
Okay. There will be a dance when we hit 1,000 for the Tony's Tackle, but I'm going to have to take your word on it. Woo! Right, so the good news is
we have hit 1,000 subscribers for Tony's channel, so cue the music and... and cut! That's it.
Right, I'm going to ask if I can't message Tony because I'm using the phone. Whoa, here we go. Here we go. That's on the rod that's just got a bit of fresh out lug on a really long throat. They do something really exciting. Considering the number of bites I'm getting tonight, and I've only landed one fish. Oh, hello. Off them rod is going, going, going. Oh, I've got to wind it around. I've got to wind it around. Well, I don't know.
Something on there,
I
felt it, but then
suddenly
it went.
Just had a stonking bite on that left hand rod. Trying to get this camera set up. Just dropping batteries and bits of camera components in the shingle.
Another target species achieved tonight. Yeah, Billy Bob, what do you think of that? What do you think of that? It's well made up. I mean, it's not a monster. Well pleased with that. Forty-five centimetres. Well pleased with that. Just a little pose, but well pleased with that. Let's get it back. And cue the music. And second dance of the night.
Whoa. It's all happening. This one's just a flat line, I think.
Feels like there's something on here. Ah. There we go. Gone from the sublime to the ridiculous. Little pouting. That wasn't the bite you saw, because I think the baits have gone on the other hook. Micro pouting. Well, I think you'll agree, it's been a pretty good night so far. I mean, I haven't caught a lot of fish. Oh, hello. Activity on my left-hand rod again. Yeah, well, actually, that is pouting, I reckon. There's three baits out there. We'll leave it running for a bit, see what happens. But doing something slightly different tonight. I'm doing a lot of filming of the actual bites, and not so much of the rest of it. But, you know, it's been a busy night. The non-stop bites, look at that. I mean, anybody'd say it was the whiting we're in, but they're not. We're not catching any whiting at all. We would be catching them. So, I've had one pouting, one flounder, and one very nice bass so far tonight. But I have had non-stop bites all night. Yeah, it seems to be on there, doesn't it? Now I'm running out of wrap lug actually, so all I've got is fresh outs now. I've got go through those pretty quickly, Ross. I started putting them at three paternoster rigs. I'm trying to use them up on the right hand rod, which has got a bolt rig on it, sort of up and over pulley rig, with quite a long trace, with the idea being a bass will pick up and run off with it and then suddenly get hooked. Is the plan. Maybe we'll put a circle hook on that, see if the circle works. Anyway, I'll get back to you when... Come on, Billy Bob, come on. Come on, okay. Come and say hello to the people. Come on, get it. Come on up. There you go. There's Billy Bob. He's chased a fox already. He's in fox hunting mode. Look at him. Yeah, I don't know what he'd do if he ever caught up with one. I kind of noticed that his running speed kind of slows down as he gets close to them, but it keeps him happy. Not seeing any around now. I mean, the one he chased did run off, but he didn't run after it, he ran to where he'd seen it, and it was long gone by the time he got there, so. But give me a little bit of exercise there, mate. Are you still on that left hand rod? I've got three hooks on there, let's leave it out there and see what happens. You know, if I've got a string of pouting, then so be it. But yeah, thanks very much for being with me, and we'll carry on. As soon as something happens, I'll start you again. Catch you later. That's the solo. Fresh out on the bolt rig. Come on, bass. Oh, and the left end rod's going as well. Looks like there's something on here. Let's hope it's not just a little whiting or a pouting or something. Looks like it's got some weight. It's giving the odd little nod. Water's edge. We got here. Come on, come to daddy, another little bass. Another nice little bass. Not as big as the last one. Woo! That was lucky. That was lucky. We measure him and get him back. Don't you spike me, mate. The bass bolt rig strikes again.
Here we go. Another little beauty bass. So there's not too much bright light on there. And it's
43. So actually, it's only a centimetre smaller than the other one I had. So let's go and get him back. And he's gone. There's like something on here. Yeah, it does feel like there's something on here. Oh, there is definitely a fish in the surf. I think we have a smorgasbord, we have a dogfish, and a plaice. What on earth is a plaice doing at this time of night? Look at that, a sea in the dark place. How unbelievable is that? Feels like something on here. What have we got here? Oh, shit, another species. Yeah. Little doggy. Einer Kleiner dog.
Think about that.
She had just started alive. There's a bass. Not a particularly big one. Was it? Thirty-eight. So we'll put him back to go and grow up to be a big fat boy. Tugging well. Still tugging well. Tugging. What have we got here? Oh, still tugging well. Ooh. There we go. What have we got here? What have we got here? Is that another bass? Little bassy, isn't it? Yeah. Our fourth bass of the night. There we go. Another nice little bass. Go another little bass for the score. I don't know what length it is, but it's not very long. 34. Going to be the last fish of the night. Yes, No. No, 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 no fish. Bait's still pretty much wrecked. So, well, what a cracking night on the beach. Four bass, two dogfish, a plaice, flounder, pouting, loads of action, loads of bites, which I didn't connect with. No codling, but you know, I've got a feeling a couple of those bites might have been codling. So, hook size, rig, I don't know what we need to be doing. But yeah, cracking night on a beach. Thanks very much for joining me for that one. Catch you on the next one. Keep safe, keep sane, keep fishing. Keep sane.